Hi guys, this is my second time posting a video on how to apply screen guard on ROG 3. Even though I'm applying this on my ROG 3, but the steps will be same for all the phones out there. The first tempered glass was from Glazed Ink and I did not have any problems with that. But unfortunately, the glass was cracked at two places and I had to apply a new one. I bought this glass from Flipkart for 192 rupees only. The packing looks good here and the glass comes in this hard box providing extra protection. Inside the box there are two wipes, one of them is wet and the other is dry, and these are numbered as 1 and 2. The glass itself comes in this smooth plastic white cover which you might have seen at local shop. On top there is a sticker saying it's for Asus ROG 3, and let's check this out. So guys, this is the glass we have and it looks pretty similar to the previous one. There is a cutout for speakers on the top and there is an opening for front face camera and the LED notification. We can see a spacing for proximity sensor. This one is covered unlike the glass from Glazed Ink. There is also a cutout at bottom for the speakers. So guys, I don't see any problem with the glass till now, and let's get on with the process of applying the tempered glass. If we see both the glasses side by side, they both look similar, but the Glazed Ink glass is probably 1 or 2 millimeters more wider compared to this glass from Case Villa. Let's clean the phone with wet wipe numbered as 1. Make sure your hands are clean, and you have to do this very patiently because some particles will be stuck to the screen and you don't want that to happen. Now let's clean those droplets with dry wipes, and this is the most important part and the final process of cleaning. We don't get any dust stickers with this like the way we got with the Glazed Ink glass, and I don't think it is required as well. So guys, once you are done with the cleaning, have a good look at the phone and make sure there are no dust particles. Now let's remove the plastic covering from the glass. I did face difficulty in removing the cover since there was only one tape attached to it and that came off, and I felt they should have done a better job here. With some struggle, I was able to remove the cover, and now the main part is to apply the screen guard. There are two ways of doing this. One of them is to try aligning the screen guard with the entire screen of the phone like I did in my previous video, and the way I am going to do here is by aligning only the speaker's cutout with the top of the phone. So guys, it's looking good at this point, and let me just leave this, and I think it's covered more than 90% of the screen, which is a good sign of right alignment. There will be surely some bubbles and you have to drag them to the nearest corners. Now let me insert the phone in the case, and I don't see any problem of the screen guard coming off on the corners like I had with my previous screen guard. Let's check the fingerprint sensor now. So the fingerprint sensor is also fine. Let me check this once again to double confirm. Initially, I had a feeling that I had applied the screen guard correctly, but when I saw the top of the phone, I could see some misalignment. The horizontal part seemed fine, but near the slope of the speaker, it was more towards the right side, probably by 2 or 3 millimeters. At the bottom, it's fine and it is aligned properly. Also, I could see on one side of the screen that it is visible, but it is very less, maybe a millimeter or two. I also get a feeling that if it were the glass from Glazed Ink, it would have been fine because it's a little bit broader than this one, but it's a trade-off as well. Even if there is a slight misalignment, you'll face the problem of the glass coming off from the corners with the case on. So I would say this screen guard is better and 50% cheaper as well. Having said all these, I don't think this should be a concern. At least for me, it doesn't bother me much. In spite of all these issues, I was happy how it turned out, because it's not that we do this daily, and my only motive of making this video is to make sure you don't make the mistakes which I did in my second attempt of applying the screen guard on ROG 3. Also, I'll be having the link of first video in description in case if you haven't watched that. So the conclusion of this video is, you can buy this glass and all the best applying it on your phone. I hope this video was helpful, and if you have any more questions, you can comment below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.